The Doomlords are a Chaos Chosen team owned by the mysterious Overlord of the Lead Citadel. No one knows who this figure is, but he's clearly very powerful because the team is never wanting for money or fresh new recruits. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint a miniature in the colour scheme of the Doomlords using a Beastman Runner for our example. But by following the methods and techniques we're going to show you, you'll be able to paint the entire team. So without further ado, let's get started. As with any Citadel miniature, the first thing you actually should do once you've built them is undercoat them. And for this miniature, I've chosen to go for Mechanica Standard Grey Spray, which you can see I've used just here. This is an excellent starting point for the colours we're going to be using on this miniature. The first colour we need is a base paint, and it is Mournfang Brown. And as always, remember to give all your paints a really good shake before you use each one. We're going to be using quite a lot of this because it's the starting colour for the flesh and the fur as well. So for that reason, I've chosen to apply it using a medium base brush. But you might want to go for a large base brush instead if you prefer. Whatever the case, so you just need to get some of this paint and put it onto a palette like this, because doing so allows you to add a little bit of water to the mix. Don't need very much, just a small dab mixed in like that, but what this does is thins the paint down, so it'll go a little bit further and it'll dry smoother as well, avoiding brush marks in the paint, and also it'll keep all the details nice and sharp as well. So once you've done so, all you got to do is make sure your brush isn't overloaded, and then it's just a matter of applying this to all the flesh and all the fur as well. Don't worry about other details at this point, because if you do catch them, well, we're just going to paint over those later on as we add more colours to the miniature. So for now, just focus on the flesh and the fur. If you do see any of that undercoat showing through once you've applied it, and I'm getting a bit of that just there, it's not a problem. Just let this colour dry, then apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. Now that we've finished applying that base coat, we're ready to carry on blocking in some other colours on the miniature, so what we're going to do is run through them quickly now because they all follow the same technique. First of all, we need Skaven Blight Dinge, and this is to paint the black details, such as the trousers and also the gloves, and then we're going to be moving on to Rhinox Hide for all the brown leather straps. After that, we'll need Lead Belcher, and this is for all the silver metal details, followed by Mephiston Red for all the red armour plates. Finally, we need Xandri Dust for all the bone details, such as the horns and the hooves. But first of all, we're going to need Skaven Blight Dinge, and this time I'm going to apply the paint using a medium layer brush, because now we need a bit more control. Now we need to watch out for the details that we want to keep brown, so this brush is really good for that kind of thing. So again, get some paint in your palette, and then add some water to the mix so it's nice and thin, about that kind of consistency there. Then make sure your brush isn't overloaded, like that. And then all we need to do is start painting in the trousers. So looking at around here, and this time you can see what I mean about being careful. You just need to be really neat around that part there where the trousers meet the fur. And as before, if you find the undercoat showing through, just apply a second thin coat before you move on to the next colour. The next colour we need is Rhinox Hide, and this is for all the leather straps. Again, just being really careful now of all the colours we've already painted in so far. Next up, we need Lead Belcher for all the silver details. So this is things such as metal rings that we've got around here on the chest, but also things like belt buckles. And also don't forget to spot any little metal parts that you may have on the bottom of the hooves as well. We're now ready to add some Mephiston Red to the model for all the armour plating, and with this colour you will need to apply two thin coats. And finally, use Xandri Dust to base coat the horns and the hooves. Now that we've finished blocking in all those colours, we're ready for the next step, which is to add some shade to the miniature, because what this is going to do is give some real depth to it and help those details stand out more as well. Now we're going to use two shades in this miniature. First of all, Agrax Earthshade, which we'll paint all over it. It's an ideal shade for all the colours we've been using so far. But then we're going to use Norn Oil, and this is to darken down the parts that previously we painted with Skaven Blight Dinge, just to push them a little bit further towards black. So first of all then, we need Agrax Earthshade, and because I'm applying a lot of this, I'm going to use a medium shade brush for it. And as always, I recommend you use a palette here. This time you don't need to thin the paint down with some water. In fact, with shades it's better off not to. But having the paint on a palette like this just allows you to gauge exactly how much you're applying at once. And towards the end of painting the miniature, you will need less new brush, and it just helps out with that. So once you've got the paint on your brush, all you need to do is start painting it all over like this. And you'll see the colour runs into all the recessed detail and gives us some nice definition. It will take a bit of time to dry. About half an hour will be good for this miniature, and it's important that it's completely dry before you move on to the next step. Also, when you're applying this much shade, you'll find that it tends to run a lot towards the bottom of the miniature, and it will pool around towards the base, and in fact, around the hooves, you'll tend to get quite a lot around there. If you spot that happening, just move away the excess paint with your brush before it dries. Once the shade is completely dry, we're then ready for the next shade, which is Norn Oil this time, and we need to be much more precise about where we apply it, so I'm using a medium layer brush to help out with that. But what we're looking to do here is to paint it just over the parts that we base coated with Skaven Blight Dinge earlier on. So in this case, we're looking at the trousers and also the gloves. The shade is now completely dry and the miniature is looking great. And in fact, if you wanted to, you could leave it here and just move on to basing it. But if you want to take it to the next level, what you need to do is add some highlights to it. And that's what we're going to do now. Now, the first area of detail that we need to highlight is the fur. And for this, we're going to dry brush it with two colours. First of all, Goldfag Brown, followed by Ushabti Bone. And the technique for both of these is going to be exactly the same. What you need to do is get hold of a small dry brush. And to do this, you just get a small amount of paint on the tip of your brush like this. Then get some tissue and use it to work the paint into the bristles like this, getting rid of the excess paint. You want only a very small amount left on your brush before you start to apply it because the application is quite specific. What you're looking to do is to lightly draw your brush back and forth across the texture of the fur. So you can see we've got some down here. What I'm going to do is go across the fur like this, so you see the paint just catches the raised detail, gives us some nice highlights really quickly and easily. Now, it can be a bit tricky to control this technique sometimes, especially around finer details such as just here, so just be careful not to go quite up to other details with other colours on them. Just keep a short distance away, like this. Once you finish with that, it's then time to do a second dry brush, this time of a Shabti Bone, and just a bit lighter than the previous one, just to add a bit more of a sharper highlight to the fur. With the dry brushing complete, we're now ready for the next step, which is to return to Mephiston Red and reapply it to the armour panels because the shade has darkened them down quite a lot and we want them to be brighter on the finished miniature. So back to Mephiston Red, this time with the medium layer brush. But what we're going to do here is be a bit more specific about where exactly we're going to apply it. Rather than painting it all over the armour, we're going to look to avoid recessed details where that shade settled and darken the red down. So as always, use your palette to get your paint ready, making sure your brush isn't overloaded. And what we're going to do is take a look at this armour panel that we've got on the forearm just here. So you can see this part here, I've got four rivets and you can see the recess around it, a lot of shade settled in those parts. So what I'm going to do is apply it to this panel like this, but avoid those recesses, not going quite the way into those parts there like that. So we retain the depth of the shade, but we also get a brighter colour as well. Now that the armour's brighter, we're ready to move on to the next step, which is to really pick out those details and begin to highlight the miniature fully. First of all, we're going to highlight all the skin using Scrag Brown. And what we're going to do here is use a small airbrush to apply this because we need to be very careful about what parts we pick out. So as always, use your palette here, but make sure you thin your paint down just a little bit more than we have been doing. So a slight bit more water, just to make sure it's flowing easily. And this is just so that we've got lots of control over it. You want to get a fine tip on your brush as well by just twisting the bristles together. And we're looking to essentially paint some lines here. So a good way to practice is just painting some lines on your palette there like that. It also helps you gauge whether the paint's thin enough or not. And you want it down to about that sort of point before you start applying it to the miniature. What we're looking to do here is to pick out all those features on the skin. So we're looking at things that really stand out. If we look at the head, for example, we've got a very strong jawline there. So what I'm going to do is just paint some of this colour just running across there like that. Then we've got, of course, the lips down here. So we just want to pick those out there as well. And just there, we've got the nostril going up there as well. You see, all the time, I'm just looking for these stronger lines and then just picking them out with a little bit of colour as well. We've got this line just going down the side of the neck just there too. So I'll get that as well. And just along here as well. So it's just a matter now of going all the way around the flesh, picking out features such as this. With that highlight applied, you can see the detail on the skin is standing out really nicely. And if you want to, you can then add a second highlight to it just to bring it out a bit further. For this, we're going to use Cadian Flesh Tone, still applied with a small layer brush. And the technique is much the same here, only being even more selective about what parts exactly we pick out. We're looking for the really fine details here, the really sharp features. So as before, make sure your paint's nice and thin. A bit more water, I think. There we are, that's about right. And then make sure the brush isn't overloaded. And this time, as I say, we're looking for the very sharpest, finest features on it. So a really obvious example is the tips of the ears. So you can see what I'm going to do is just paint a small bit of this colour, just the very tips of them there like that. We also want areas such as around the mouth, the jawline, the fingers, all these kind of very sharp details. And with that highlight applied, the skin is complete and we're now ready to highlight all the remaining details on the miniature. So we're going to run through those quickly for you now because the technique is much the same. First of all, we need Dawnstone to highlight all those black details like the trousers, followed by Mournfang Brown to highlight all the brown leather straps. After that, we'll use Ironbreaker to finish off all the metal details, followed by Wild Rider Red for all those red armour panels. After that, we'll use Ushabti Bone to add a highlight to all the bone details like the hooves and the horns, and then we'll add Screaming Skull to those as well, just to really finish them off. But first of all, we need Dawnstone, so I'm still going to use my small airbrush to apply it, and as always, use your palette to get the paint ready. I'm just going to make sure it's nice and smooth before we apply it, so down to about that point there. I think actually, there we go. Make sure the brush isn't overloaded, and what we're looking to do now is to go around all those black details, picking out the raised features. So on the fabric here, you need to go all the way around the edge of it where it meets that fur, being as neat as you can along there. But also look out for any creases as well, such as the ones we've got around here, and just pick those out as well while painting a line just at the top of the very top of that crease there like that. The next colour we need is Mournfang Brown, and this is to highlight all the brown leather straps. So just follow along all the edges of each of these straps like this. Now ready to highlight all the silver details using Iron Breaker, still with a small layer brush, and just be really careful with these ones as all these details are very small. The next colour to apply is Wild Rider Red, and this is to highlight all those red armour panels. So again, just following along all those sharp edges and corners. We're now ready to highlight all the bone details, starting out with the shabty bone. And again, what you want to do here is follow along the raised ridges of the horns. So we've got these lines going all the way up there, and there's one in the centre as well on each one. And we can see we've got these little raised parts going down the side too. So be sure to pick those out as well. Now for the hooves, what you want to do here is just create some texture on them by just painting some vertical lines just running down like that. You don't have to do loads, just a couple there like that. And one other part to pick out at this stage as well is the teeth. And for this, just be as neat as you can as you pick this feature out. And finally, finish off the horns with a fine highlight of Screaming Skull just along the very tips of them like this. Now, once you've done this, your miniature's ready to be based. And as always, we recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your team. So with the base fully painted, this Beastman Runner is complete, ready to join his team on the field, blitz and gore his opponents, and sometimes you might even remember to try and score as well. So when painting this miniature, there's a few things to remember. The first is that when you do that all over shade, just keep an eye on it as it dries because it will tend to run and collect towards the bottom of the miniature. If you don't move away the excess paint, it will dry with quite a horrible effect, so keep an eye out for that. Also, when you're dry brushing the fur, just remember to try and focus it just on the main areas of the fur. It's very easy to catch details that you don't want to paint by accident, so just try and be as neat as you can during that step. So there you go. Now we really hope you guys have enjoyed this video and learned something from it, and we really hope you have fun painting your Blood Bowl team as well. And we'll see you all again soon.